Good morning. With First Up here on Headlines today, our top focus this morning is on the NDA government's Swachh Bharat Abhiyan that the Prime Minister kick-started this morning from Rajpath. These are live visuals that we're getting you of the walkathon that the Prime Minister is spearheading. Atif Khan, our deputy editor, I believe, is also there at the walkathon, walking right behind the Prime Minister. Atif, take us through what's happening there right now.
Well, you see, there's a lot of excitement here, and the Prime Minister was not scheduled to walk for so long, but it was a spontaneous move on his part, and he knows very well that he has to, if he has to associate his association with this campaign, is absolutely essential, and only then it could be a success, and that is why he's made up his mind. He's now, we are walking along with him. It's been more than 1 kilometer's walk. The security officials are finding it very difficult, very, very difficult to control the situation here. Though there is control crowd, but then there are children who are very excited. They are raising slogans in his praise, and he has been cordoned off. The Prime Minister, as he's walking, the top security officials have made a sort of a human chain, and they're surrounding him so that there's no security breach. But then the Prime Minister has made up his mind that he'll be out on the streets for this campaign. There are lots of people who have come here, gathered here. And as we speak, he's walking alongside, there's a huge gathering here. He's moving towards now the Gandhi Smriti. Very soon, at the moment, he's on Suneri Bagh Lane and road, and then he will be near Gandhi Smriti. Thereafter, we do not know how long he's going to walk, but he's walking with great enthusiasm, and he's been surrounded by people all around.
All right, Prime Minister heading that walkathon there on Rajpath, accompanied by hundreds of people who are following him. Atif Khan reporting that the Prime Minister wasn't actually scheduled to walk the entire distance. The SPG having some trouble keeping fans and onlookers at bay. Atif, we'll keep coming back to you. Let's also get in a word from our guest who we have with us in our studios this morning. Mr. Dilip Cherian, image consultant, is with us in our studios. Also with us, Ms. Reena Gupta of the Aam Aadmi Party. Joining us from our Patna studios is Mr. Gopal Krishnan, environmental expert. I'm going to come to you first, Mr. Dilip Cherian. What does this do for Narendra Modi's image? He's already a powerful persona as far as the social media is concerned. He's constantly asking people to interact with him and connect with his portal online. Now launching this Swachh Bharat campaign, himself wielding a broom, something that no other Prime Minister has ever done, clearly trying to connect with the people.
You know, wielding a broom and marching on the street is great, but he's even gone further because he's clearly taking this campaign onto social media by setting out a challenge for people from the podium, saying that he's nominating people to do the same elsewhere, and cutting across party lines and including not just film stars and actresses, but also Congress people. So I think that in a sense, he recognizes that this is not something to be confined to Delhi and to the studios or to the newspapers, but needs to spread through social media. And he's in a sense broken yet another new ground by doing this in an active sense. You know, so far it was just messaging, but now he's expecting video links from people to see what they actually do.
Also asking for mass participation, asking people to spend 2 hours every week in trying to clean up their environment. Let's also get in a word from Mr. Gopal Krishnan, an environmental activist who's joining us from our Noida, from our Patna studios this morning. Mr. Krishnan, a mere publicity stunt, or do you actually see this translate into something concrete?
It is good that cleanliness has been made a political agenda. For a long time, issues of waste management, issues of cleanliness have not been on the political agenda. As of now, it does appear ritualistic, it does appear to be an exercise in propaganda. But if it does not develop depth, if the cleanliness drive does not develop with the passage of time, it will be time for the entire political class to ensure that the issue remains is made political. And it's not only about customary photo opportunities. Cleanliness is actually a political issue. And for long, the issue was away from the public glare. It is a welcome initiative, I would say, that the entire issue has been brought in the public space, and it made it not only ritualistic remembrance on.
Right. So we're getting reactions from the ground. Actor Aamir Khan, who also shared the stage with the Prime Minister, saying it's an issue that he's also taken up in his own television series, Satyamev Jayate. Let's also get in a word from Ms. Reena Gupta, who's with us in our studios this morning. Ms. Gupta, it seems that when Arvind Kejriwal picked up the broom, it was more in a symbolic manner to try and clean up the system. Now, Narendra Modi quite literally saying that everyone should pick up a broomstick and clean our neighborhood, our office spaces, our homes. Do you think that the BJP successfully been able to steal the broomstick from the Aam Aadmi Party?
See, first of all, I would say that we at Aam Aadmi Party, we welcome this initiative. I think everybody in the country would agree that we need to clean the nation. We are probably one of the dirtiest nations in the world. But, you know, at the same time, the nation is dirty not because we litter. It's dirty because we don't really have a long-term vision on how to take care of our waste. You and I, you know, we'll listen to the Prime Minister, he's energized the nation, we'll clean our neighborhoods today. But what will happen to all this waste? What are we going to do with it? We are going to dump it in the Ganga and then have another Ganga action plan to clean the Ganga. So, you know, as of now, I would have actually wished that the Prime Minister went a step ahead and actually talked about a vision on about what to do with the waste. Right now, all it seems is let's clean our streets, let's clean our cities. The waste is not in my backyard. What happens to it? It gets dumped in the ocean, it gets dumped into the Ganga or wherever, it doesn't matter to me. Second, if you really want systemic changes in the way the waste is handled in this country, then we really need to look at the functioning of our urban local bodies. Let's look at Delhi, MCD, which has been controlled by BJP for almost 15 years. What have they done? Zero. Delhi is drowning in dump and excreta. Why? Because there is large-scale corruption in the MCD. So we need to fix that. Third issue is that, you know, who at the end of the day, it's going to be the safai karamcharis who are going to do this cleaning long-term. Let's look at the conditions of the safai karamcharis. They work in inhuman conditions. Let's improve their working environments. Once we improve their working environments, we can also talk about fixing accountability of those karamcharis. So, you know, I wish the Prime Minister would talk about all of those issues. As of now, it looks very symbolic, but I really wish that it is more than symbolic.
All right, so basically the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan needs to be a little more comprehensive. Waste management is an issue that also needs to be addressed by the government. Thank you all of you for joining us this morning for our special coverage on the NDA government's big launch of the Clean India campaign.